Hey everybody, it's Eric over at Breakthrough Broker. Thanks for joining me today. We had so many people sign up for an effective open house webinar. It's crazy. As usual, everybody, please type in the chat where you're calling in from. I love to know where you guys are calling in from. I am in Denver today, believe it or not. So back home in Denver. Lee, where are you at?
I'm in Michigan.
Michigan, awesome. So we have Salem, South Georgia, Austin, Texas. Hello, everybody. Welcome. We had over 1,000 people signed up for effective open house webinar. So I think we're still ready to learn after everything that's gone on in the last week or so. Everybody, welcome. Thanks for joining. Thanks for being willing to learn and get out there. We'll have fun today. We're going to take another minute to let everyone get in and settled. Thanks for telling me. We have Mexico. I love it. Kalispell, Bozeman, Bend, Phoenix. I was just there this week. O'Fallon, Billings, San Antonio. Welcome, everybody. It's nice to see. It's almost springtime. So Minnesota, I see. I like that. You guys have gotten some snow lately, huh? Minneapolis, California, no more. Austin, welcome everybody. Thank you. And keep coming in, keep getting in. We're going to get settled. We're going to do effective open house marketing today. I think it's going to be fun. We have our sponsor on this morning, Lee with Town Sites. I traditionally, those of you that know me and have been on our webinars, I always do a little commercial for our sponsors because that's how Breakthrough Broker can survive. But this Town Sites is so cool. I wanted to invite Lee to do a little 30 seconds about what it is. If you guys haven't seen, you know, recently, if you're a fan of Gary Vee, he's really been preaching, be the mayor of your town, of your neighborhood, of your local area. And so that's what this does for you. So I'm excited. I'm going to turn it over to Lee here in a second, but let's let everyone get settled in. We'll get started. We're only 2 minutes after 10 my time here in Denver. So welcome everybody. Las Vegas, Sugarland, Ashburn, welcome everybody. Jupiter, that's awesome. I'll be in South Florida this weekend, so that's fun. All right, everybody, let's get started. We're gonna start on time. This is being recorded. And Lee, you have 30 to 45 seconds to tell us how amazing Town Sites is and what it is.
Under pressure, I need 5 minutes to tell all the things it does. Town Sites is a hyper-local AI digital marketing tool that will help you effectively stand out as the go-to agent in your community. We help improve your digital footprint, especially on Google. We help you cost-effectively reach buyers and sellers in your community all the way down to the subdivision. We seamlessly create a community-based B2B network for you to build off of and create a profit center. And we turn your community platform into a revenue generating machine. We use artificial intelligence to scrape your local community news in real time. And we rewrite those articles with you as the author and present you guys as the go-to professionals in your community, all while we're raising your social platform, especially on Google My Business, your LinkedIn, all your other platforms. So it's a great tool to help you stand out as the go-to agent.
I love it, guys. I think this is, you know, we only take on sponsorships that we believe in. When I was selling, being the mayor of the neighborhood was a goal of mine. This technology didn't exist. So it also, there's some level of exclusivity, Lee, correct?
Yeah, one per community. So it's limited. Once you own your community, it's yours.
Marita, Marita, please put the links put them in here for everyone to see for Town Sites. We will, there will be some links also when we send the recording out this afternoon. So Lee, thank you for being our sponsor. Thank you for caring about Breakthrough Broker users and our community. And we appreciate everything you do. And I love doing business with you, buddy.
Thanks.
All right, I'm going to get started, guys. We are here to talk about, I'm going to remove you, Lee, so you can go back into you might need to re-log in, okay?
Okay.
All right, there we go. I'm back, everybody. Let's talk about open houses. At the end, maybe we'll have some time for Q&A on the NAR settlement if you guys care or want to talk about it more, or if you're NAR settlement out, we don't have to talk about it. Well, let's talk about open houses today. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Eric Sachs. I'm the co-founder over at Breakthrough Broker. So I'm excited that all of you came on today to talk open house marketing. So we're going to hop in here and we're going to jump in and get started. So welcome to the Open House Marketing Guidebook. We're going to talk today about effective open house marketing. Thank you to Townsites once again for being amazing and for showing our users what this is all about. The mission. What's the mission of doing an open house? You know, I did a lot of open houses and drove a ton of business from open houses. If you can't tell, I love talking to people. And so I think it's important. Sometimes we get into this robotic rhythm of doing things just because. I'm doing an open house because everyone else is doing open houses. I think I'll just print off 30 MLS sheets, stick them on the counter, and go sit there, right? And I think it's really important for us to remember that right now, what's really important is having a goal. What's the mission? Why am I getting up and doing this? So for me, the mission is to generate a mass amount of conversations in order to convert open house attendees into people who need you to help them buy or sell a home. I'm going to repeat that. Generate a mass amount of conversations in order to convert open house attendees into people. Did you notice I said people and not leads? Really offended by the use in our business of that word. They're people, not leads. So drive a lot of people to my open house so I can find other people that want to buy and sell a home. That's why I'm doing an open house. So why did I go through the motions? Guys, remember, type in questions in the chat. I will get to them as we go. All right. I will get to the questions as we go. All right. But I think it's really important to, yes, we will have a link to the printable guidebook as well. I think this is, Marita just put the link out there for everybody. Have a goal. I was just thinking, it's hard when you're looking at the chat and you're trying to answer questions. I got into a rhythm of not doing effective open houses. I got into a rhythm of thinking I had to do it to please my seller at the time and to just feel like I was doing something in the business to build some momentum. But I, at first, was printing off 30 MLS sheets, black and white, sticking them on the counter, putting out like four signs and being frustrated at my open house that not enough people were coming in. It's then I learned from another colleague in the industry, this concept of mega open house. And that's where we kind of go today. Let's look at the numbers of effective open houses. I think we're still looking at the mission, right? The mission is to drive the maximum amount of conversations so we can find people that want to buy and sell a home, period. It is a lead generation marketing function, okay? So let's look at what three open houses effectively marketed a month could do for you. Three open houses a month. Let's say our goal is to drive 15 people or 15 couples, but 15 individual buyers or sellers to each open house. That is attainable. We should crush this number, okay? But let's just say 15 is our goal. That's 45 conversations a month if we do three a month, which is 540 conversations in a year. If we continue to look at these numbers and we take 540 conversations and we say, let's say half of them already have a realtor, real estate professional that they're working with. So, you know, you come in, are you working with a realtor? Yes, I'm working with a realtor. And half of them, Marita, I'm getting some comments that they're having trouble downloading it. Can you just make sure that link is working? 540 conversations, half of them are working with a realtor. So let's just say 270 potential new clients from three effective open houses a month. Okay. If we close and or convert on 5% of those 270, that's 13 new closed clients in a year. So let's say your average sales price is $500,000, 13 closed clients is $6.5 million in sales volume. Okay. If any of you guys were on my business planning classes in December and January, I needed to sell 18 homes to have 9 million in gross sales volume to bring home $270,000. And then pay taxes and my commission split we remember that business planning stuff. But so for me, if I could knock off 6.5 million in sales volume when I only needed 9 in one marketing function, that's pretty amazing, right? I only need one or two more to hit my goals. So if we look at this, I need to do this effectively to convert on 5%. If that conversion goes up to 10%, do the numbers. And obviously I'm not putting commissions in here anymore, but you do your own commissions. For me, 3 effective open houses a month is gonna mean 6.5 million in gross sales volume. Crazy, right? If we look at it that way and then we start to market it correctly, we're going to come ahead on our goals for the year, right? So let's move on from here. Effective open houses. Now we know that if we have a mission, the mission is to create as many conversations as humanly possible. From those conversations, we put all of the people that don't have a realtor partner, real estate agent they're working with, into our CRM. And then we follow up with them and we convert about 5%. We know how much money we will make by doing this marketing function. It's part of our marketing plan in a 12-month span. So let's do a great job at our open houses. Let's start. Effective open houses start with research and planning. Research and planning. If it's not your listing, a lot of times we're doing an open house to find people that want to buy and sell a home. Maybe it's not our listing. Maybe we go to a brokerage meeting and we find a new listing. We go to that listing agent and say, do you mind if I do a couple open houses this month for you? No problem. Knock your socks off. Great. I'm going to do open houses to find buyers and sellers because I really want to stay in this business. Okay. If it's not your listing, review and know the property details. If it is your listing, you should know these already. What amenities does the neighborhood have? What parks and walking trails, and does it have a neighborhood pool? And what unique features does the home have? What renovation history does it have? So part of your research, if you're doing an open house for another real estate professional in your company, interview them, ask them, tell me everything about this house. What's unique about it? What do the sellers love about it? Okay. Be prepared to answer some unique questions. Why are they selling? If you can answer it, if you have permission, ask the listing agent. What schools does the home feed to? Know the schools, elementary, middle, and senior. Okay, understand that. You know, you can, that's a factual statement. Yes, people are like, you can't talk about schools. Well, you can. If you're not giving your opinion, you can say this school is where it feeds to. That's a factual statement. Okay, guys. So we're going to keep going. Be prepared for these frequently asked questions. Okay, guys. Know and understand what the sellers most loved about the home. Again, ask the listing agent. And if you are the listing agent, ask your sellers, if you haven't, what do you love about the home? That is a great thing to be able to answer, to build rapport, to build trust at an open house for you. Okay, guys. So research and planning up front, super important. Research and planning, know the competition. You've probably heard this before and you probably did it early on and you got a little complacent in your open houses, but get with it again. Know the comparables, know the comparable property details. What's active within a mile or half mile or in the neighborhood? What has sold in the last 3, 6, 9 months within a mile, half mile in the neighborhood? If you want to really be amazing, print that out, have it available to talk about. Maybe, and some people are like, that's a lot of work. Maybe go preview the active listings in the neighborhood before the open house. So you can have an intelligent conversation about what's listed within a mile, half mile, and inside the neighborhood. So you can talk about, this home doesn't fit your criteria. I saw a home four blocks over this week. Let me tell you what it has. By the way, I get done here at 3 o'clock. If you want to see it, we can go see it. Okay. So we're going to keep talking about research and planning. It's super important. Prepare the answers for the frequently asked questions about the competition. So why is this home listed at this price when that home sold at that price? Why is that home actively listing at that price when this home is listed at this price? Be prepared. You're not there to open the door and let people in and watch people walk out. You are there to drive business. There's no other reason to do an open house than to drive and find buyers and sellers, period. Whether it's for that house or if you're trying to build your business and build momentum, if you don't do this, there's no reason to go, right? If you don't do your preparation, if you don't understand what's going on around the neighborhood, there is no reason to go, all right? Familiarize, I knew I'd have trouble saying that today, yourself with the neighborhood and attractions. Drive around. Make sure you know where the park is. Make sure you know where the entrance and exits are in the community. Have the comps printed out, maybe. Highlight important features like public transportation, parks, restaurants, shops, schools. Understand all of that. It makes you better than the other three or four real estate professionals they meet that day. It makes them wowed by you because when you follow up tomorrow, you want them to remember you. Oh yeah, that was the guy that knew all that information. Because open housers typically are open housing if they're not using a realtor and they're going around looking at what's out there. You want to be better than the competition. You will be remembered based on your answers here when you follow up. Super important. Let's talk about marketing. Effective open houses, mega open houses. This is where we crush it. When I say we want, the mission is to create as many conversations at every open house. So we have 540 conversations at the end of the year. The only way to go about that is to market them well. You can't just put four signs in the around the neighborhood, print off a black and white flyer, cross your fingers and hope people show up. A lot of us do that. But in reality, we have to proactively market to drive people in so that we can have as many conversations as humanly possible. Pre-open house marketing, idea number one. 7 days prior to the open house, send a VIP open house invite postcard to the closest, whatever you want, 50, 25, 50, 75, or 100 neighbors. If you mail that out through us on Friday, it's going to get there Tuesday or Wednesday, 3 to 5 days. So you want that postcard to say VIP open house. Come see what your neighbors are selling their home for an hour before the general public Saturday morning. Can't wait to meet you. It lands on Wednesday. Don't put the price on the postcard. VIP open house. Come see what your neighbors are selling their home for 1 hour before the general public. We want to drive conversations. Remember, it's not just buyers we're hoping for. We're looking for listings. You can get listings at your open houses if they're properly marketed, right? So we're going to keep rocking and rolling here, okay? VIP open house. 25, 50, 75, or 100 neighbors. Whatever you can stomach in your marketing budget. Okay, guys? Send a postcard to your sphere. Okay? Remember, takes money to make money. We'll talk about the ROI, $6.5 million in gross sales volume. You do the commission calculation on that. Do the hourly wage on that, and you should market your open houses better. Spend a little money. Now, you can't send it to your whole sphere, so choose groups. If you're doing three a month, My weekend open house is on a postcard. If you love real estate and you miss me, come visit me at my open house this weekend. That's all it has to say. Whether they come or not, you're reminding the people you know that you are the go-to real estate agent, okay? You're reminding the people you know that you are the go-to real estate agent. My weekend open houses. If you love real estate and you miss me, come visit me. You can post that also on your socials, okay? Pre-open house marketing to drive more conversations. Start posting on social on Wednesday before your Saturday, Sunday open house. Okay. Story posts. We have all this on Breakthrough Broker. Open house carousel invites. Inline posts. Post them on Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn to your not paid promotion, just regular social posts. Okay. Now, paid promotion, you can do paid open house promotion on Facebook and Instagram. We have a video on the Open House Guidebook from our partner to do open house paid social marketing. It's Walled Garden, Travis Tom. So in the guidebook you downloaded, go to paid Facebook and Instagram advertising, and you can do geographic advertising based on a certain area. And so that's in there with a video from Travis on how to do that. All right. So now we sent an email out. We know all about the open house because we did a ton of research. We sent a direct mail postcard out. We started posting. We sent it to a few of our sphere of influence. We're doing some sphere marketing too. So we're building momentum for our business out of one weekend open house. And let's keep going. Okay. Let's keep going. Pre-open house door hanger the day before. VIP open house. Come see what your neighbors are selling their home for an hour before the general public. You might be like, well, I don't want to do that. Well, enlist your kids to run around the 25 closest homes and put them on the door, or use TaskRabbit. We're going to talk about TaskRabbit for signage too. TaskRabbit is like a gig economy. It's a website for people to get paid for doing tasks for you. And so you'll put in TaskRabbit task, put out 30 door hangers on Friday afternoon or Friday morning. And I'll provide the map and the door hangers and meet you at the neighborhood and pay you when you're done. So super simple. We sent a postcard, we hung a door hanger, and we did some social media marketing. Okay. Let's talk about day of open house. How do we set ourselves apart? Remember, we want to have, this is being recorded, guys, the most amount of conversations humanly possible at our open houses so we can convert a percentage and find buyers and sellers, people that want to buy and sell their homes. This is one way, a very good way of lead generation, okay? I believe it's a money better spent than on Zillow and realtor.com and Lead Tiger, whatever else you're using. This is a better way because you're selling yourself, you're in person. So day of open house, what are we doing? Signage, oh my gosh, I hate it. It's the worst part of open housing. I used to hate having 20 signs rattle in my trunk and stopping and getting out. I'm dressed nice. I'm putting a sign in the yard, And in Denver or in Colorado where we had our brokerage, it was snowy sometimes. It sucked. I hated it. But very, very, very important. Appropriate signage. Okay, guys. We ended up when we were doing our mega open houses, we did this is crazy, a sign at every right turn within a half mile radius. At the time, we also bought eye level signage. So it was a stake. It wasn't a tent on the side of the road. We put a stake in and it was high and it was open house this way, open house this way, open house this way, all the way to my open house. I've talked to some big teams that put out 50 to 100 signs. They use TaskRabbit. They meet TaskRabbit in a parking lot, hand them a map, say, here's all the signs, take them out of my car or trailer or truck, put these out. Here's half now. I'll pay the rest when you bring them back to me at 3 o'clock today. See you then. Signage is super important, okay? Leverage Craigslist gigs or TaskRabbit or someone, so you don't have to go do that. Your time is better spent at the open house preparing. But make sure signage is appropriate, abundant, and you're driving people in from a large geographic area to your open house. And old school still works, guys. I'm going to tell you a quick story here in a second, but balloons, flags still work. Okay. Don't put them on all 50 signs, but as you get closer, maybe one balloon, maybe two balloons, maybe three balloons. And when they get to your house, I know that sounds terrible. But I'm going to tell you guys a quick story. I'm going to stop sharing for a second. Hopefully I can find my presentation. Sometimes it gets lost. So let's find it real quick. So here I found it. We're looking for a home right now. Okay. We're looking for a home right now. And I was by myself and I decided I wanted to go look at an open house in an upscale neighborhood of Denver. And it made me so frustrated with our industry. The open house instructions on Zillow actually were poor. And I got to the neighborhood of the open house and there was no signs. And when I found a sign, it was actually really confusing. I didn't know if it wanted me to turn at the alley or on the street. So I was already confused. I finally got to the home and the entrance was around the back alley with no signage in front. So I had to walk around, and this is a high-end luxury listing. I get in and the agent has four other people in there. No welcome. She didn't even look at me. There was a MLS listing on the table. No, nothing else. No sign-in sheet. How did that realtor, like, what if my wife wasn't a real estate agent and I didn't have a real estate professional? No sign-in sheet, no conversation, no, nothing but a MLS sheet on the counter. I had to walk around. I had to look at everything and guess what everything was. There was no signage on the walls. There was nothing told me what anything was. And I wanted to ask her a question, but she was actually talking to the same person the whole time I was there. Okay. So I left without asking a question. She didn't know who I was. I am a viable buyer. And I left so disappointed. And I want you guys to know and understand that it is our duty to provide the consumer with what they need. And if we can wow them, even though I had a realtor, a good portion of the agents walking in don't. So I don't know if you guys have a similar story, but me going through it as a potential buyer just made me so upset at this particular agent. I was like, man, you're missing out on a lot here. So I wanted to tell that story before we move on. Make sure your signage is good, appropriate. If it's around back, tell them to come around back, but be good at what you do with this, okay? How many balloons do I recommend? I don't know, Amelia, just enough to draw attention. I don't know. We want to draw attention. You can be sure that your competition isn't drawing enough attention. I drive around all day and I see a few signs here and there, and I'll drive by the house and I got to drive back to the house because I missed it. So just make sure you're making it easy. Okay. Welcome sign. So we have welcome signs on Breakthrough Broker. Stick a welcome sign at the house. Why? I don't know. Give some direction. Stick a sign. Welcome to the open house. Here's a QR code. If you want all the pictures of this open house to a single property website when you're done, some interesting facts about the house or at the table, make sure you read them before you leave. I don't know, but it's important to be dialed in on this. Make sure you have a sign-in sheet easy to find before they tour the home. Greet them with a value add. I'm going to talk about that in a second. Hey, welcome to my open house. I'm glad you found it. Okay. Make sure you sign in before you take a tour of the house. And here's a house hunting checklist to help you today. Oh, you brought the family today. Wonderful. Here, kids. I don't know if you're sick of looking at houses. If you are, here's an activity sheet. Here's a thing of crayons. Enjoy yourself while your parents are touring this home. Build rapport right away. This open house activity sheet for open house is actually you branded for you, not Breakthrough Broker. Has your logo on it, your name information. It's the best way. It's one of the most downloaded assets on Breakthrough Broker to build rapport with families walking in the open house. Are you welcome? Are you guys out open housing today? Looking at a lot of open houses. Awesome. This might help you. This is an open house comparison chart. Make sure you use house one here to ensure you remember everything about this house. And as you go throughout the day, I hope this chart helps you. In the end, when they get home, it's got all of your information and your logo. Remember, not Breakthrough Broker, your logo on it. Some of these ideas are ideas you may or may not have thought about before, but it's important to provide value to stand out, because what do we want to do? Have conversations and then have them work with us as a buyer or seller. Okay. So all this stuff, really important. Some additional day of considerations. Curb appeal. I don't know. Maybe take a spin by the home the night before. Make sure the lawn is mowed. If it's an apartment complex, like where I went, it was like a townhome, road homes, and there was no parking instructions. I didn't know where to park. Make sure we make it easy for them, and we want to make a great first impression. The minute they find it easily, they had great instructions, they get out, it looks amazing, we're good. Okay. Welcoming environment. Guys, this is real estate 101. We just got away from it. Make sure it's not too hot or cold in there. If your sellers want them to wear shoe covers, provide a bunch of shoe covers that are easy to put on. Guys, this sounds hokey, but sensory appeal is important. Cookies, coffee, candles, make sure the lighting is perfect, a little music if you can. It's still important. It still shows who you are to create an experience that makes them want to use you when they walk away. Okay? When they walk away. Additional day of considerations. Again, information station. Set up a spot. Set up a spot when they walk in, where you have the sign-in sheet, property brochures, some comps. Maybe you put the comps up on a map, your business card, house hunting checklist, some of those coloring sheets that I showed you, the feedback form. Have a little station there. Maybe that's where you give them water or coffee or sodas and snacks, but have it all well thought out, right? Open house engagement. What are you doing? Remember, it's the mission. Remember the mission about having conversations. Don't be a wallflower. Don't just stand there and let people in and welcome. Please sign in, pick up a sign-in sheet, have a nice tour. Welcome, please sign in. There's water over there, have a nice tour. Engage. Welcome each guest personally. If you're tied to, don't talk to one person like the open house I went to. For the whole 20 minutes I was there, she talked to one person. You have to learn how to disengage and engage. Provide them with an overview and invite them to explore. Hand them a clipboard maybe with some information on it. What's nice about handing them a clipboard is they have to stop back with you when they leave. Here's a clipboard. Here's a comparison chart, an open house, house hunting checklist, and a feedback form. Bring this back to me when you leave. Right? So we're when they come back to you, that's when we can engage them. What did you think? Oh, let me look at your feedback. Oh, this wasn't for you. You're looking for five bedrooms. Did you know there's one down the street at five bedrooms? Let me know if you need help getting in. Okay. Don't hover, but be available. Don't hover, but be available. Okay, guys. Be the captain of the open house. Make yourself known. There are introverts on this call, and you can be successful in real estate as an introvert. But bring an extrovert with you to your open houses. I want you to be the captain of the open house. I want you to be seen. I want you to be heard. I want you to be the expert. If we're going to convert people to buyers and sellers at our open houses, you need to make yourself known. Okay, guys? Understand that this home may not have been, you know, they check in. I understand this home might not have been for you, but if you love the neighborhood, there's some other homes on Cookway for sale. There's one two blocks over. Just make yourself valuable, okay? Encourage feedback. Again, like I said, this is where you can start a conversation. Some alternative strategies. Twilight Open House. Nathan and I, my business partner, used to do open houses from 5:30 to 7:30 on Wednesday evenings. We called them Twilight Open Houses. We advertised them. We did the same kind of mega open house advertising. We always had more people at our weekday Twilight Open Houses than our weekend open houses. People are coming home from work. People are thinking about moving. People want to know what a home is worth in the neighborhood, but they're coming home from work. They will stop by. Twilight Open House, it works really good. Okay? It works really good. Mark asks a really good question. What's the best method for getting attendees to sign in? Oftentimes you hear we're just looking. I love that. And I think there's two ways, Mark. For my safety and security, the sellers are requesting that everyone sign in. If they refuse, then they don't get to see the house. I'm sorry. I understand you're just looking. So hopefully there's some other open houses you can see today. They have to sign in. Really, that's not a lie. For my safety and security, the sellers are requesting that everybody sign in. And so if someone refuses to sign in, they don't get to see your open house that day. Hopefully you're driving enough people willing to sign in to see the open house, okay? So hopefully that works, Mark. Hopefully that answered your question. Twilight Open House, try it, guys. If you're looking to drive momentum and traffic and things are a little stale, try a weekday evening open house. Exclusive open house events. The marketing says exclusive. Invite your sphere of influence. Invite other realtors. Invite the neighborhood. Exclusive open house event. You see these on like Millionaire Real Estate Agent where they do these events at these $14 million penthouses in New York City. But those work, guys. Exclusivity. It can be a raffle. It can be an event. You can partner with local businesses. I've seen great open houses that partner with artists. That's like the open house event. Please come to our open house today. It's open for 4 hours and we have local artists providing their art, or we'll have a coffee shop there providing coffee, or we'll have, you know, the local Mexican food place has chips and salsa and breakfast burritos for us. Whatever it is, try these things out, guys. They work, okay? They work. So alternative open house strategies, Twilight, exclusive, broker open, you know, those are kind of a thing in the past in some markets. I like them. I like talking to other agents. I like doing a separate open house just for real estate professionals to come see my listing, to give me feedback, to interact with real estate professionals. I think it's a great thing to keep doing broker open houses. Post open house, this is the most important part. Everyone who doesn't have a realtor goes in your CRM. Okay. Everyone who doesn't have a realtor who comes to your open house goes in your CRM. I said it twice. That's important. We're going to interact with them to convert them to a person that wants to buy or sell a home with us. Okay. Or a lead. I hate that word. Person who wants to buy or sell can be converted from someone we just met to someone who wants to work with us, but you have to follow up. Send information to the attendees within 24 hours. Thank you for joining my open house. Here are four other homes that are similar in the area. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for attending my open house. We just made a price improvement, $5,000. Thank you for attending my open house, whatever that may be, okay, guys? We just went under contract. If you're still interested in the neighborhood, call me. The follow-up is where you'll get the business, okay? The follow-up is where you'll get the business. Remember the mission. Remember the mission. I want to close, and this is we're getting there, and I want to answer some questions. I do want to close with open house safety. Some of you may or may not know, my past life before I opened a brokerage and got into Breakthrough Broker, I was a police officer for 13 years, 7 years youth crime detective, and 6 years patrol. Open house safety is important to me. I'm passionate about it. Do not be complacent. It drives me crazy when I see people marketing open houses on social that says, I will be here from. Just change the I to we, okay? Your marketing should say we. I don't care if you're by yourself. Don't tell someone you're by yourself in the world. So we will be. Find a we. Your affiliate partners want to help you. Your mortgage partners, your title partners will join you at an open house. If it means safety for you, if it's rural, if it's in the middle of nowhere, bring a partner, okay? Bring a partner. Team up. Check in with people. Tell, you know, your significant other where you'll be. Have escape routes. And I'm going to tell you a quick story. My wife is a realtor here in Denver. Her open house was about 8 minutes away from where we lived. This was not last summer, but the summer before. She called me and said, Eric, there's a strange guy out front on a motorcycle. He drove around twice. Now he's just parked looking at the house. I sped over there as fast as I could. I parked right next to him, looked at him, walked inside, shut the door. He stayed for about another 5 minutes looking at the house and he left. I was positive that her senses went off and she was right about not feeling safe. So guys, make sure you're doing all of what I told you safely. When I say escape routes, that means when you go to do your open house, open the back door. Don't leave it locked. Open the door into the garage. Maybe even open the garage door. Don't leave it locked. Don't go into a basement by yourself with an open house attendee. Don't go into a bedroom by yourself with an open house attendee. And this goes for men and women. Men and women. If we look at the statistics, as many men in real estate have been robbed and assaulted as women. So this goes for both men and women. Be safe at your open houses, and they will absolutely turn into new business for you guys. Okay, I want to thank Townsites again, and I do want to make sure you guys look into Townsites. I ask a favor of all of my Breakthrough Broker users. If you love Breakthrough Broker and you love what we're doing with and for the industry, please just check out our sponsors, because they help us do what we do to provide 5,000 pieces of interactive content for you guys. We're building some AI and automation that I think you'll love later this summer. So let me answer some questions here. Is there anything different that can be done for 55 plus community? I don't think so, Yelena. I think 55 plus is you can market similar, right? You can market to that same community. You can invite them to an open house. You can invite them to see what their neighbors are selling for. I think the conversation could maybe change for you, but I think the marketing is similar, right? If we invite someone at the open house, like a yoga teacher or something like that, whose responsibility is it if something were to happen? Oh my gosh, Gloria, I have no idea. Ask your broker that. I think, you know, you could have a little waiver before you do yoga at an open house. I think the yoga teacher could have a waiver. I'm not sure what liability you have there. What are the best times for an open house? Great question. I don't know. I believe time blocks in the morning and or afternoon. I believe in the middle of the day, your people who open house in the middle of a Saturday or Sunday, it kind of ruins their whole day, right? So in my opinion, if you do an open house in the morning and or afternoon, so 9 to 11, 1 to 4, if we leave the middle of the day open, then a person can do whatever they want personally, then open house, or go open houses and then go enjoy their weekend. Not that open housing isn't enjoyable, but that's my opinion. You asked what time. I think morning or afternoon. I try to avoid middle of the day. So I hope everyone was able to get that download. Twilight open houses, what time? We did when people were on their home commute. I did 5 to 7 or 5:30 to 7 or 4:30 to 7 would be a great twilight open house. You know, 4:30 to 7, 4:30 to 6:30 is perfect in my opinion. So again, guys, thank you for joining. I hope this was helpful. Thank you to Townsites for being, you know, a badass partner of ours. If I was in real estate today, I would buy Townsites for my local market because I want to be the mayor. I want everyone to think of me. And guys, I don't know what to tell you about the NAR settlement. if I were you right now, I would just put the pedal to the metal while everyone else is freaking out and everyone else is arguing and paranoid about this business. If you continue to market yourself, you guys will be ahead of everyone else come August, September, October. So just keep crushing it, guys. Thank you so much. And we'll talk soon, everybody.